All right, so probably the most common misconception with knife disarms is that they don't work, which makes complete sense because most of the time, people who get knife disarmed, Steph, are pulling them off like this, which are feeds, right? Which isn't bad, but unrealistic. The most common way that somebody's gonna stab you is how? Like this, you're gonna get shanked, right? So how do we deal with this? If we try our typical way of defending, it's near impossible for me to catch. It's like catching fish, right? But if you do like a shotgun and a pistol approach, this is my shot. Like think of it like the target. You want to use as much aim as you can with the most surface area. So as you get stabbed, first of all, you don't want to back out. You want to come in. But you want to use this as your safety net to catch. So even if this one doesn't come in, it's okay. Because push, I have my body weight on this arm, right? This one is extra insurance, right? So from here, we've caught them, right? And then what happens next? They're gonna want to pull back to stab you again. You actually use that with your momentum and either underhook, right, from here. We're at a stalemate though, so try and move your arm. If I keep this arm straight, I'm good, right? Move your muscle. Yeah, I'm good, okay? Or if you want the more effective one, as you get stabbed, pull in, you do the overhook, which is a lock. And from here, use all your muscle. I'm good again. Because I'm using my framing to keep the knife at bay, right? And from this position, what I can do is I can effectively push on this joint with my elbow and bring them down. Right? Resist. Use your muscle. Bring them down. And that, we feel, is the most effective self-defense technique. Not this. Catching. Oh, step. No.
Double?
Yeah, double. Not like this, but in fact, going in, catching it, and then continuing from there.